Thank you. That concludes the debate on adult mental health. It is now time to move on to the next item of business, which is an urgent question, and I call Megan Gallagher.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. To ask the Scottish Government what its response is to reports that Creative Scotland was aware that the project REIN, which received £76,196 of funding from the organisation, had scenes that were of a sexually explicit nature before awarding its funding.
Cabinet Secretary Angus Robertson.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. As is right, judgments on individual applications to Creative Scotland are for that organisation, which is entirely at arm's length from ministers. However, it is imperative that Creative Scotland can command the confidence of this Parliament, not least its Culture Committee. That's why I called the Chair and the Chief Executive in today to make clear my expectation that they should make themselves available to the committee to fully and transparently answer any concerns that are put to them. They've given me the assurance that they will make that offer to the committee. They've also sought to assure me that new processes have been put in place to introduce safeguards to ensure the recent issues are not repeated.
Megan Gallagher.
Creative Scotland knew back in March 2023 that REIN's application would involve a sex scene with genital contact involving three members of its cast. In a letter to the Constitution, Europe External Affairs and Culture Committee dated the 16th of April from the Chief Executive Ian Munro states, as became clear in March 2024 when the project team developed new contents for their website and publicised that as part of a call out for participants, one new and significant difference emerged which took the project into unacceptable territory. That was the intention to include real sex as opposed to performance depicting simulated sex in the work. Presiding Officer, FOI's release yesterday shows that this was completely untrue, and that REIN were clear in their application in 2023 what their theatre performance would contain. So can I ask the Culture Secretary if he would confirm unequivocally that he only knew yesterday that Creative Scotland lied to Parliament?
Cabinet Secretary.
I can confirm that the details of the material that was released by FOI was only seen yesterday by myself, that I had concerns about it, and that is why I immediately asked for the Chairman and the Chief Executive of Creative Scotland to meet with me this afternoon in the Scottish Parliament. They did. I asked them because I knew that there were interests across the Chamber, and I have spoken to colleagues in all of the political parties this afternoon to let them know this, that I have asked that they come to answer detailed questions that can be put to them in committee, and no doubt Megan Gallagher will do exactly that.
Megan Gallagher.
I am still concerned about the nature in which these details have emerged, Cabinet Secretary, but the truth has now been exposed and tens of thousands of pounds of taxpayers' money has potentially been lost. So given the Chief Executive, Ian Munro, appears to have deliberately misled Parliament, MSPs and, of course, the boss of the SNP, Quango, does the Cabinet Secretary agree with me that his position is now untenable? And if he does agree with me, why hasn't he sacked him already?
Yeah. Cabinet Secretary.
Well, just on a matter of employment law, the position of the Chief Executive of Creative Scotland is for the Board of Creative Scotland. I'm sure the member knows that. But in the interim, can I make the point that where serious questions are to be asked, they should receive serious answers. And that is why I pressed on both the Chairman and the Chief Executive of Creative Scotland that they should avail themselves of the opportunity in full to speak to members of the committee, including Megan Gallagher, so they can be satisfied both about the circumstances that she clearly still has major concerns about, but more than that, about what systems are in place now to make sure that no example of this kind of project getting funding happens in the future.
Megan Gallagher.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I still don't believe that that answers the question. Does the Cabinet Secretary have faith in Creative Scotland? Does the Cabinet Secretary have faith in the Chief Executive, Ian Munro, yes or no?
Yeah.
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, I have been given assurances today that he has the full support of the Board of Creative Scotland, and as a Cabinet Secretary that understands that it is not for the Cabinet Secretary to determine arm's-length organisations. I think there's agreement across parties still on that point. I hope there is, that in these circumstances where there are still questions to be answered, I am very keen that all Members of Parliament, including Megan Gallagher, are able to do that, and I expect that they will avail themselves of any opportunity to brief members of the committee.
Jackie Dunbar.
The apparent disparity between the documents recently obtained regarding the initial assessment of the funding application and the evidence later provided to the committee by Creative Scotland is deeply concerning, as is the apparent lack of transparency there has been since this situation initially came to light. Given these concerns, what engagement has the Cabinet Secretary had with Creative Scotland with a view to fully understanding how this situation was allowed to transpire and what steps can be taken to restore trust in the organisation's internal operations?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, having the concerns that I did, I acted immediately and invited the Chairman and the Chief Executive of Creative Scotland to come to my office within a day to explain the circumstances and also to explain what course of action is being undertaken to make sure that this example cannot happen again. More than that, I want to give members of this Parliament who have the responsibility serving on the committee which has oversight for culture that they are able to ask any questions that they wish off Creative Scotland. I have asked that they should make that offer. I expect that they will, and that members from across this chamber will be able to ask any questions which they see fit and relevant.
Neil Bibby.
Libraries are closing, kids can't get music lessons, festival funding is being cut, and at the same time Creative Scotland awarded tens of thousands of pounds of public funds for an extreme sex project. I demanded the original application be published because we needed full transparency. And now it appears, despite Creative Scotland's claims, explicit content was explicit in the application. This should never have been awarded public funding in the first place. In the information released yesterday, it appears that as early as September 2022, within a month of funding being awarded, there were concerns within the agency about this project. Given what we know now, can the Cabinet Secretary explain how Creative Scotland can still maintain the nature of the project had changed? And has he had an explanation from Creative Scotland about why warnings from within the organisation were ignored? And does he agree the lack of transparency on this has been unacceptable?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, firstly, it is for Creative Scotland to explain the decisions of Creative Scotland. I would have thought that that's an obvious point that political parties that recognise the independent nature of arm's length organisations. I'm not here to undermine something which is more than a convention. It is absolutely at the heart of how government is supposed to operate. Does that mean that I have not had concerns? No, it doesn't. I have had very serious concerns. Neil Bibby knows this because I've spoken to him about it only today. What I think is really important, given the assurances I've been given, is that they are given to members right across this chamber. That includes Mr. Bibby, who's a member of the committee. I have asked that Creative Scotland come before the committee. Mr. Bibby will be able to ask any questions that he sees fit, and he will be able to take the consequences from the answers that he hears from Creative Scotland.
Mm-hmm. Ash Regan.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Can the Cabinet Secretary confirm what substantive steps the government will take to rebuild public trust by ensuring full transparency and good governance across all organisations that are receiving government funding? Or will the government just risk waiting for the media to uncover further scandals?
Cabinet Secretary.
No, I've been given very clear undertakings about the changes that have taken place in Creative Scotland. This is the first example of its kind where a project like this has been funded in the way that it has. They agree with the government that it is an unacceptable situation. They have already taken steps to change their processes. I expect both the committee to be updated on those and members of Parliament who are not a member of that committee to assure them that the necessary changes for the oversight and safeguards that the member rightly raises can be shared with all members around the chamber. And I'm sure Creative Scotland have been listening very closely. I know some people's attention is elsewhere at this particular time, but I'm sure they have been listening very closely, both to the questions that have been posed and the answers that I've given.
Thank you. That concludes the urgent question. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 13318 in the name of Jamie Hepburn, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme, and I call on Jamie Hepburn to move the motion.
It moves, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. No member has asked to speak to the motion, and the question is that motion 13318 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 13319 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on a stage 2 extension for a bill. Any member who wishes to speak to the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on Jamie Hepburn to move the motion.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. No member has asked to speak to the motion. Therefore, the question is that motion 13319 be agreed. Are we all agreed? The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of 3 Parliamentary Bureau motions, and I ask Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move motions 13320 and 13321 on approval of SSIs and 13326 on substitution on committees.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. The question on these motions will be put at decision time, and there are 2 questions to be put as a result of today's business. The first question is that motion 13291, in the name of Richard Leonard, on behalf of the Public Audit Committee on Adult Mental Health, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. And I propose to ask a single question on 3 Parliamentary Bureau motions. Does any member object? No member objects. The final question is that motions 13320 and 13321 on approval of SSIs and 13326 on substitution on committees, in the name of Jamie Hepburn, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motions are therefore agreed, and that concludes decision time. And we'll now move on to members' business in the name of Alexander Burnett.